former Prime Minister, the Right Honourable Raila Odinga, to make his brief remarks. Welcome, Mzee.
Mama Martha, Mama Grace, the Nyachae family, fellow mourners, God is good all the times. We have come to pay tribute to a great Kenyan. And I'm standing here on behalf of the family of Jaramogi Oginga Odinga. Our families have got history. The late chief, Paramount Chief Musa Nyandusi, was a friend of our father. And as Simon would say, he took his elder son, Ayako, after whom Charles is named, to Jaramogi when Jaramogi was a teacher at Maseno High School. And told him, "Huyo mtoto nimeletea wewe." Jaramogi took Ayako and paid his school fees, and Ayako used to live in our house in Maseno. The first time I came and met Mzee Nyandusi was a small boy in 1954, when I was told by my father that tomorrow in the morning we are going to Kisi. Then I did not sleep. Early in the morning at 3 a.m. we took off. Those called box bodies. The journey would take 3 hours, arriving in Kisi town at 6 a.m. And Kisi was very cold. So we went to a friend in Kisi Hospital, the late Mito Jura, who received us, gave us hot tea, after which we then drove to Mzee Nyandusi's home. And we found Mzee there who welcomed us. And as we were taken aside, as they were talking now with Jaramogi and late Mito Jura. That was my first encounter at that time. And that story Nyachae would tell me several times we met. The story of how they would come together. So when Jaramogi became the Minister for Home Affairs, when he was in charge of Africanization, and provincial administration was under him, that's when he promoted Nyachae to become the District Commissioner at that time. There is another friend we shared with Simon, late Job Umino. And we would sometimes sit, Grace knows the corner where we used to sit, and discuss very many issues, history. Job and Simon had attended the same course at Cambridge University, those days when they were being trained to become civil servants. So we were great friends. Then another friend we share is Mzee Madenge there, who was also a fellow permanent secretary, a great friend of Simon's. Madenge there was very much committed to freedom from hunger walks. And he drafted Simon into it, and Mudia Wori. We'd walk together, freedom from hunger. I remember one time as we were approaching Wayakiwe, I started getting cramps. And Zimadenge and Simon came to my aid to help me to stretch up so that I could finish the walk. I was actually very surprised that older people were able to make it and I was actually going to fail. So we were friends. But a lot has been said already about Simon. But there's that human part of him. He was a very compassionate person. But he also lacked efficiency. Trained in the colonial culture of efficiency. So he has helped so many Kenyans to acquire education. When you go to the United States, you'll find villages filled by Kenyans who were actually beneficiaries of Simon's generosity. You go to New Jersey, you go to Texas, you go to Minnesota, where my friend, the deputy governor, was. Very many Kenyans there. Many sent to India, to China, all over the world. So he's made a tremendous contribution to our country. When he became a minister, I was a member of parliament. And we were, of course, opposition, and he was in the government. But we worked very closely together with Simon as a minister for agriculture, later minister for finance at that time. Later on, when he had resigned from the government and was in opposition, we again worked together. When we started the Rainbow Coalition together, he came with four people, and we were ourselves, we had come from, broken away from KANU, and we formed the Rainbow Coalition together because they had negotiated with the late Job Omino. However, when we now teamed up with NAK, to form NARC, we had an issue when I said Kibaki Tosha. That did not go down with Simon. And he would all the time keep on reminding me how I betrayed him. But he remained friends generally right through. So we are actually saying goodbye to a great Kenyan patriot. A man who has done a lot in the service of this country. And we want just to say, may the Lord rest Simon's soul in eternal peace. Thank you.